We're going to break down and point out one of the most overlooked and important things to know about tires and how something so small can make a major impact. Do we really know what tire sipes are? What exactly do they do? How do they work? And how do they affect the performance of the tire? Invented and originally developed by John Sipe in 1923 because he was sick and tired of slipping on the floor of the slaughterhouse he worked at, so he cut a bunch of little slits in the bottom of his shoes with his butcher knife and found out that it actually worked and gave him much needed additional traction. But what exactly is a tire sipe and how exactly do they work? See, a sipe is a small slit in the tire's tread block that creates an additional tread surface for increased grip. As a tire rolls, the sipes will open up to take in water or snow and remove it from the contact patch of the tire. Sipes also create extra biting edges of the tread blocks that enhance the tread's grip for a variety of different driving situations, like hard braking, cornering, evasive maneuvers, and acceleration, particularly useful when the roads are covered in ice, snow, rain, or even loose dirt and sand. Sipes will also help fine-tune each tire's handling along with its ride quality and wear characteristics. Tire manufacturers will increase the number of sipes on all season, all weather, or three-peak mountain snowflake rated tires, and particularly on snow tires, including the use of 3D computer designs of sipes to create that variety of differently shaped sipes that go in multiple directions and are cut up in the tread blocks in a variety of depths, depending if it's the shoulder lugs or center tread blocks. The deeper the sipe goes into the tread block, the more that tread block will flex and twist, which isn't going to be that great when you're on the road, slamming on the brakes, or an emergency maneuver situation to avoid some sort of collision, and the tread blocks are literally folding over themselves and losing their traction. In those types of situations, you'll want the tread block to be more rigid and the sipe to not be cut in so deep, so that it maintains its rigidity and its contact patch with the road, and in turn, maintains its traction to the road surface. Too many sipes on a mud tire, or sipes that are too deep, can cause the tread blocks to flex more than they should, and the rubber will start to fatigue and become too soft and pliable, and will cause more damage than good. When this happens, the tread block will actually start to separate from the rubber carcass of the tire, eventually getting to the point where the tread block will tear right off. That's why you'll see most mud tires, not all but most, have very minimal siping throughout their tread blocks to add extra strength to each tread block. Like the Nittle Trail Grapplers, for example. They only have one center sipe per tread block to increase the strength of the tread blocks, therefore withstanding much more abuse than tire treads that have a higher quantity of siping. The downside to limiting the amount of sipes in the tread blocks is that they are not going to perform that well on the road when there's snow, water, or ice, so it is a trade-off. Same reason you don't want to run snow tires that have a ton of siping on them through the summer months. One, the high number of sipes allow the tread blocks to be much more pliable, which is great in the winter, especially in the snow or on the ice, but will wear out much faster and not perform as well on warm, dry pavement. Another performance characteristic of sipes is, not only are they there to help evacuate water and prevent hydroplaning, but when it's well below freezing outside and you're driving through the snow will actually pack itself into the sipes, creating a high friction situation between the snow in the sipes and the snow on the road. So now that we have a basic understanding of what sipes are, how tread sipes work, along with how they affect the performance of the tire, the next question is, should we get a set of tires that has a lot of siping, a fair amount of siping, or little to no siping at all? And this is where, once again, this is a very subjective question, and it's important to consider how much driving is done on road in dry weather conditions, crappy weather conditions, and how much driving is done off-road. Maybe it's a dedicated trail rig and siping really isn't all that important, or not as important as the design of the tread or stickiness of the tread compound. Do you live in a dry desert area and rarely see rain and even less likely snow or ice? I can say we rarely ever see anyone running trail grapplers up here in Wisconsin, but we sure saw our fair share of them when we were just down in Moab. And guys, if you are looking for a decent amount of siping on your next set of tires, an easy and simple way to search for tires with more siping is to look for an all-season, all-weather, three-peak mountain snowflake rated tire or dedicated snow tire, and then look in that all-terrain and rugged terrain or hybrid terrain category as, just like we talked about before, there aren't going to be many mud terrain brands of tires that have models with ample amounts of siping throughout the tread blocks. Not saying there isn't any other mud tire out there that doesn't have a lot of siping, because the Milestar Patagonia, Cooper STT Pro, and Mickey Thompson MTZ do have some additional sipes throughout their tread blocks, but still not as many as you'll find on the hybrids and all-terrain or rugged terrain tires. So hopefully this video has helped out in one way or another, and if you guys do have any experience to add about siping, or even if you guys have any questions on siping, definitely make sure and let us know in the comments below. All right guys, well, that is all that we have for you today. Remember to hit that subscribe and thumbs up if you enjoyed today's video. And guys, as always, we appreciate all of you for watching and all of your support. I'm Josh from Trail Built, and we'll see you guys out on the trails.